Morning, class 9. Let us continue the same chapter, Five Kingdom Classification, chapter number 5, or chapter number 8. So far, we were learning about invertebrates, the different groups under invertebrates. In the previous class, we learned about Porifera, then again followed by Coelenterata or Cnidaria, then again after that, we learned about Platyhelminthes. Now today, we'll be learning about the remaining groups of invertebrates. And they are Nematoda, which is also called as Ascalminthes. Nematoda, then after that, Annelida, then after that, Arthropoda, then followed by Mollusca, and then finally, Echinodermata. In each group, you'll find so many different characteristics, okay, but still, as I told you before, only a few characteristics you need to remember, the most identifying characteristics of each group that you need to remember and learn. Only two or one hardly is asked in the examination. So I have selected a few selective characteristics of each group, okay, which I will be explaining you today. So first comes Nematoda. About the platyhelminths, we learned that they are the flatworms. Now these nematoda are actually the roundworms, also called ascalminthes. Okay, roundworms. All the roundworms are categorized under this group. Now, what are the characteristics of these nematoda? The first one is, we have learned that platyhelminths, they are the worms which are usually flat. Now you can see here, in nematoda, they are usually long, cylindrical, and then again, unsegmented bodies, not segmented by any partition wall and all. Okay. And with false body cavity. Their body remains filled with the fluid. Okay. They do not possess the true body cavity. So that is why they are often categorized under the group oscillomate. Body cavity means silom. Okay. Oscillomate. They are often categorized under the group oscillomate as they be a false body cavity. So, what we observe here, nematoda, how it is different from the flatworms, they usually bear long, cylindrical, unsegmented body with false body cavity. And then the next difference, we see that the flatworms were with a single opening called the mouth. But here, nematoda, they are with two openings. They are elementary canal bears, two openings, mouth as well as anus. Okay, mouth as well as anus, and like flatworms, they are also mostly parasitic. The best example which you require to remember is Ascaris and hookworms. Okay, so this is about the group Nematoda. Now let us move on to the next group, Annelida. Annelida, when the name comes, see, you need to remember the example like leeches, scientific name Hildunaria, then again artworm. Peritima postuma is the scientific name of earthworm. Okay, leech, earthworm, all belongs to this group. Okay, now whenever you describe, right, the characteristics of annelids, then you just visualize earthworm. Okay, and then write down earthworm. They usually have cylindrical body, so cylindrical. Okay, and their body is segmented by rings. Okay, segmented body with true body cavity. In nematoda, we do not find any cavity, false cavity where they are. Now here, they have true body cavity. They are coelomate. So that is why we generally are categorized under the group coelomate, bearing true body cavity. Then again, like nematoda, it also bears both, its elementary canal bears both mouth and anus. Okay. So, two characteristics I have mentioned, I have included here. Then Arthropoda, which is one of the largest, okay, group of invertebrates. Arthropoda, all the insects, okay, are categorized under this group. Whether it is butterfly, whether it is housefly, whether it is mosquito, okay, they are all categorized under this group. Whether it is crab, shrimps, they all belong to this group. Arthropoda. Example I have not mentioned, you can include yourself. Now, the most important characteristics of Arthropoda is that Now see, in order to categorize any organism, any invertebrates in this group, you just check their legs. Okay, legs, appendages. Check their legs. Their legs are usually jointed. See, one joint, and again one more joint you may find here. They have jointed appendages. Mosquito is quite common. Housefly is quite common. Cockroach is quite common. Okay, you can see the jointed appendages. Okay, their legs, their joints. So, presence of these jointed legs in the animals confirms that they belong to the group Arthropoda. So, after Arthropoda comes Mollusca. Mollusca, let us talk about the body. Your body is usually soft, unsegmented. Okay, and the body, the most identifying characteristics of Mollusca is that their body is protected by calcareous cells. That is, the cell made up of calcium. Okay, whenever you write the characteristics of Mollusca, visualize snail. Snail, the body is soft, okay, unsegmented, and the body remains protected by calcareous cell. Then again, after that, the muscular feet, with the help of muscular foot, they usually look more from one place to the other. Presence of tentacles, these are there. So only two characteristics I have mentioned here, presence of muscular foot for locomotion. Okay, then comes Echinodermata. Echinodermata, the best example is starfish, sea urchin. Okay, starfish, sea urchin. Now Echinodermata, their body is again unsegmented, and the most important characteristic is that all over the body, needle-like structures are present, spines are present, their body is spiny. Okay, so that is why it is always suggested if you are walking by the beach of what you call sea. Okay, that time if you step on, if you are moving with a barefoot, step on a starfish, then this starfish usually gets poisonous. Okay, so when you stop on the step on them, then what happens? Poisons enters into your body. Okay, and the person may die also. So that is why the persons are always suggested to be very careful while walking by the beach side. Unsegmented body bearing spines all over their body. Radially symmetrical. Radially symmetrical means the body can be divided by longitudinal plane in more than one longitudinal plane. You can divide like these two symmetrical half, you'll get. So more than one, when the body is divided longitudinally, okay, in more than one plane, then if you are getting the symmetrical halves, then the body is said to be radially symmetrical. Radially symmetrical, and they are mostly marine, mostly found in sea and ocean. And then again, for locomotion, there is the presence of 2 feet. With the help of which they locomote. So these are the characteristics of Echinodermata. So after completing Echinodermata, this invertebrates portion is completed, student. So next comes vertebrata. Different groups of vertebrata we'll be discussing. In vertebrata, we have to learn about 5 different classes under the group vertebrata, starting from Pisces, amphibians, reptilia. Then again, after that comes avies. And then finally mammals, mammalia. Okay, so let us I'll be explaining that in the next video. In this video, this much. Thank you, student.